Azhar, and we present you our rover for UASIP 2021.
We are a team of 30 undergrad students coming from various backgrounds. Our team is divided into 5 domains: electronics, mechanical, coding, life science, and corporate.
This year, the system of the rover is a revision of the previous year's model with improved performance and controllability. The rover just weighs 40 kgs with all equipment on board.
The chassis frame is designed concerning durability and modularity, made up of hollow aluminum box channels to resist bending loads. The rover comprises of a 4-wheel drive system with independent suspension placed at each wheel by compression strings. The suspension allows independent movement of each wheel, which increases the stability of the body on uneven terrain and provides better traction. The 12-inch wheels, which have a wider base, provide enough traction to the rover and make it easy to maneuver through the rocky terrain. The electronics of the rover have been evolved to be highly reliable and modular, making it easy to debug. A combination of 4 and 5 cell lipo batteries are being used to power the electronic subsystem of the rover, whose power supply is being regulated by an array of buck boost DC to DC converters. The arm and the drive system have been kept completely independent, which reduces the complexity of the system. For making the drive system robust, Jetson DX2 is the primary master that communicates via serial bus with 2 dual-channel saber-tooth motor drivers controlling 4 24-volt Bainbot geared DC motors for driving the rover. For the communication, we are using a 2.4 GHz spectrum that is coupled with an omnidirectional antenna at the access point and directional sector antenna at the base station, which gives us a range of 1.2 km with low latency. We are using a 1.2 and a 5.8 GHz transmitter for analog feed of the cameras.
The rover's architecture uses robot operating system for internal communication to ensure robustness and better feedback system. The team has also developed a self-diagnostic system to check all the connections and peripherals before the operations.
A controller GUI developed on React.js is used to control the rover manually and autonomously. The speed, acceleration, and error offset of the rover can be dynamically modified, which aids in certain tasks and provides a real-time feedback from the rover to ensure secure operations remotely. The developers team have introduced focused upgrades in the autonomous traversal. The existing navigation algorithm has been refined with the addition of a stereo vision-based obstacle avoidance algorithm. Apart from this, we have also developed a new algorithm for AR detection and rover alignment for autonomous tasks. These technologies were extensively and rigorously tested and executed on Gazebo simulation for optimal performance.
The 5 degrees of freedom articulated robotic arm configuration allows for a precise and smooth maneuver of the end effector.
The arm is made up of rectangular nylon beams, which has a high section modulus that prevents bending while lifting heavy weights. Using the precise potentiometers attached to the linear actuators coupled with an inverse kinematic algorithm, the arm is able to perform highly accurate motion along a specific axis in space. The gripper is provided with a pitch and roll motion using a combination of bevel gears actuated by 2 servo motors, hence making it easier to grab and drop objects. The gripper has 2 parallel fingers actuated with a lead screw mechanism that ensures a firm grip over various shapes and can perform versatile operations. It can grab objects up to 7 cm in diameter. The maximum reach of the gripper is 1.6 meters from the ground and is able to lift 5 kgs of weight with no effort. The central board of the rover has been custom designed to incorporate the STM32 microcontroller. It communicates with the arm motor drivers for controlling the actuation of the arm and YPR system. It also manages the power distribution to the onboard PoE, the motion of the camera system and astronaut assistance box. The rover also incorporates a kill switch that will terminate entire power supply to the arm and drive control.
The science team at Rudra relies on an approach that integrates chemical testing along with physical observation to determine the presence or absence of both extant and extinct life in the given samples. The geomorphology of the rocks is studied using a movable microscope, and a drill is used to excavate soil from the required depth. A combination of gas sensors will evaluate our results on other aspects as well. Chemical biosignatures in the form of biomolecules can be detected using an array of biochemical assays. The science payload also consists of a high-speed centrifuge, which is used to optimize the results of the tests.